cut chips, you cut a thin slice of potato, and then if you slice off the skin and to cut nice even chips, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, get them all to the same length. Okay. And there we've got 6 chips. These chips will need to be weighed. Okay, you need to weigh each chip using a weighing boat. So you need to tear the balance first. Okay, weigh the chip, record the weight. Okay, keep them close so you know which one is which. So next one. Okay, so we need to make sure we've got a range of concentrations. So we need a concentration of 0.2 up to 1 molar. We've got a solution of 1 molar of sucrose. We need to make solutions at 0.2 molar. So we need to have 2 millilitres of the sucrose with 8 millilitres of water, distilled water, 4 cubic centimetres with 6, 6 with 4, and 8 with 2 of water. And that will give us a range of concentrations from distilled water with a water potential of 0 down to a concentrated solution of sucrose at 1 mole of sucrose and range in between. Label up your test tubes from 0.2, 0.4, 0.6, 0.8, and up to 1 molar sucrose. And then add your sucrose solutions in the right quantities. So if we put some sucrose into a small beaker, then we add the correct volume. So for the 0.2, we need to add 2 cubic centimetres. When you do your syringe, if you dispense to the line with the black plunger, so that's 2 cubic centimetres, in it goes. And we've got up to the line, 4 cubic centimetres. Six cubic centimetres, 8 cubic centimetres. This one we've got 10 cubic centimetres of sucrose, 10 cubic centimetres of sucrose, and it goes. You should wash your syringe and then add distilled water to make up to 10 cubic centimetres. So the first one, so we've got zero concentration, will be 10 cubic centimetres of water. And then we're going to 8 and 2. So 8 cubic centimetres with the 2. We're going to 6 with the 4. 4 with the 6, and we need to add 2 to the 8, 2 cubic centimetres of distilled water, there we are, and then these should all be briefly mixed. To mix, if you go hold thumb and forefinger and give a flick mix like this. Okay, flick mix each one. like that. Right, these tubes should then be placed into a water bath at 30 degrees centigrade to equilibrate. Now you can check the temperature of one of the tubes. When it comes to constant temperature, then you'll know it's ready to use. When your tube has come to, or your tubes have come to constant temperature, so in this case 28 degrees centigrade, it's ready to start. What you need to do is then quickly add your chips to each tube. So 1, 2. So the chips remain in the water bath there, and they should remain there for 15 to 20 minutes. So once your time is up, stop the clock, and you need to remove your chips. To get out your chips, the easiest thing to do is to tip out the solution and just tap the chip down. And then you need to block dry. So pop it onto some tissue paper, and you can block with another tissue like that, and then keep a note of which one is which. And do another one. And block dry like that, and repeat that for all of your chips. So once you've dried all your chips, then they need to be individually weighed. So check the tear of the balance. So this is 0. Take the first chip, pop it in, and record the mass. Okay. And then the next one. Record it along with the previous values. You should find that your masses will have either some of the chips should have increased in mass, some of them should have decreased in mass, and some of them may have more or less stayed the same. You'll need to plot a graph then of the difference in mass. So if you take away the final mass from the initial mass, you could then plot those values against sucrose concentration.